Welcome, fam. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's Our Reviews Will Kill You, and you've got the reunited dynamic duo, or sleepy duo. You clearly have the man you know as E, and our main man, Scott, who is asleep. Oh, look who's decided to join the conversation.
What am I doing here? How did I get here?
Magic.
What? I fell asleep. I was back home. Working on a project, dreaming of large, voluptuous women.
Like
and
the She-Hulk.
Next thing I know, I'm here. What did you do to me? And what's that smell? Oh.
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 It's new news, Mike.
How dare you bring me here and throw this? Is that food? Ugh.
Well, I needed you here so we could talk about something. There's been some breaking news, and right. It's not quite yet March, and it's the Snyder Cut. We got some. I know we covered it in our last podcast, but now, instead of blurry images, we have actual images.
We're still talking Snyder Cut?
We're going to talk about it till it comes out. And either it's the holy grail of all movies or it's the worst thing ever. Somewhere in between.
I think we're now almost a month. It's supposed to be, what, the 16th of next month?
Yes.
Yes, so we're almost there. We're looking very close now.
We're almost over the hump. So what we're going to look at today is Zack Snyder released some images of Jared Leto's redesigned Joker. And previously he had released a couple blurry images. And I guess people were like, yo, you can't just do that to us.
And if you remember, we talked about this on our episode on Friday. It was blurry images with longer hair, kind of reminiscent of like the Heath Ledger Joker.
Correct. So let's go to it. And thank you to Vanity Fair as they gave us a new look at this. And as I bring it up on screen here, we got two really good images. And I'm giving the first one, which is Jared Leto in a hospital gown, maybe in Arkham Asylum.
Isn't that the guy that passed away, but he used to sing for Typo Negative?
Ah, yes. Something Steele?
Yes, yes. Nathan Steele?
Something like that.
Something like that.
Something like that.
Looks like him.
Not quite as big. He's sitting on a lonely chair here, and he's just got himself all sorts of like... the makeup is very, very different. Let's get it. There's actually a closer look up here. Oh, look at that. It's a very intense Jared Leto. Very, very different. Do we notice anything missing from him?
Those horrid tattoos?
What are you? Horrid. I'm talking about those fantastic tattoos. What better than, let's look at those. The damage tattoo. Oh, what happened? He's missing the damage tattoo. I miss the damage tattoo. How else is anyone going to know how the Joker feels unless he displays it clearly on his head and says, I am damaged? Is that not how you discuss with people? No, you're not just damaged.
I like to write things on my forehead, but usually it's things like, leave me alone, don't talk to me.
So not your mental state, just messages you'd like the world to get out.
Yes, yes, just so like you don't have to actually look, well, you do have to look at me because I write it on my forehead. Usually I just write lonely.
Well, David Ayer clearly agrees with us as well, as he says the damaged Joker tattoo was one step too far.
Oh, interesting.
I don't know about... There's something so quirky about this. Jared Leto, I guess he's getting a second chance here. How do we feel about it? Are we... I don't know.
I'm fine with it because we know that everything that Jared Leto does is kind of weird and out there anyway. Remember him from, what was it, Blade Runner? That weird character.
Yeah, he played that weird character.
So we know that Jared Leto already can do these weird characters... So I would be curious to see what he could properly do with the Joker character without being completely cut out of a movie.
So we're going to give you a quick part here where I would recommend that you don't listen if you don't want to hear a spoiler, because how do you spoil a movie that already was filmed? But apparently only 80% of it is 80% of it is Joss Whedon, who now has more allegations against him.
I won't say these are absolute spoilers. This information.
Context.
It adds context to what we're going to be seeing with the Zack Snyder version of Justice League. We kind of danced around it before with the Batman Superman movie.
Mm-hmm.
When we saw the BVS movie, when we saw the Apocalypse.
The Nightmare Vision. Uh-huh.
So this isn't really spoilers. It is adding context. And even though it's information that I could do without, it's not information that's ruining the movie for me.
Okay. Well, we're about to tell you exactly what Zack Snyder said. He said, the one thing he does mention is that he not only is he going to wear that hospital gown, but apparently he's also going to wear a bulletproof vest festooned with the grimy law enforcement badges. Those are his trophies from, I guess, cops that he's killed. So the Joker will appear in the new film during a sequence set on a ruined Earth after the alien tyrant Darkseid invades and decimates the planet. It's a dream sequence, a psychic vision experienced by Ben Affleck's Bruce Wayne that reveals what will happen if the superheroes fail to stop the onslaught. Joker is sort of the ghost of Christmas yet to come, supplying motivation through terror.
That sounds fun. I like it. We've already seen that dream sequence before, so it's not spoiling anything. Knowing that we will see that sequence again, but instead of no context or just guessing what's going on, that you'll have the Joker there kind of as the guide through this nightmare, I think that's actually a pretty cool concept.
The only thing I've been thinking since I saw this is the makeup has me thrown a teeny tiny bit, because it reminds me a little bit of this. Where it's a small child who is wiping schmutz all over his face. Like, he literally was like, nom, 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 I love cookies.
Isn't this Noob Noob's baby photo?
It probably is, because he's in a perpetual state. That's the inspiration, is what
those,
you're saying.
And those are feces.
That's chocolate cake.
Just something just, that he's still into, which is probably why this thing stinks.
Because it's just
so bad.
The beard caked with feces, yes. Just, so I'm a little, it just looks like he smeared some stuff over his mouth. I'm not super impressed with it. It doesn't look like an evolution of the one that we see here. I don't know. I mean, it just seems like a little bit of a different iteration. I'm going to give Jared Leto the benefit of the doubt. I don't know how I feel about him at this point. He's kind of like hit or miss for me. Sometimes he's really good. Sometimes he's a little too out there. He's clearly not his method. He's not doing that. There was a little bit of a story from the most recent movie that he did, The Little Things, which we reviewed. And Denzel Washington said he would have none of that nonsense on set, where he would be sending condoms to people and other disgusting things. He's like, yeah, there's a level of professionalism on a set that I like to keep. And he's like, yeah, we're not having it. So, yeah,
sometimes you gotta have fun. I mean, come on.
Sending dead rats to people does not sound like that much fun.
Dead rats? You said condoms.
He did that too. He did. Well, I'm pretty sure there was
a little overboard on that one.
Yeah, there that just doesn't seem.
The dead rat bouquet, albeit creative.
What if it was a rat ball? Or what do they call that? Like, king rat? Is that a king rat or something?
King rat, rat ball, ball rats.
Yeah.
You know, just like a bouquet. Squids. Actually, a squid bouquet, I think, would be more preferable. Squid's edible in most cases. Rat's also edible, but you have to cook it first. I think a squid bouquet would be, if you want to send something to your baby on Valentine's Day, which is coming up very soon, think squid bouquet.
Yeah, you do that and see how far it gets you. Last point that I'd like to make is that we had there was an additional conversation in this where he did something. He would like to explore something. He says it's very unlikely, but he'd like to explore it. And, you know, I was thinking about it. You know, Batman came out in, I think, March of 1939. And the character that's almost synonymous with Batman, not quite as popular, but Robin, came out in 1940. Long mm-hmm. storied history, mm-hmm. right? We've had, what, 8 Batman movies, if not more? We don't have to count them all.
We don't have to count them all, but you think like how many iterations of Batman alone, everything from the Adam West Batman through now, through Ben Affleck,
the Rob Bat Pattinson.
Good and bad versions alike.
Well, the one thing they've never actually explored was the death of Robin, which I think is one of the most compelling and interesting stories in Batman lore. And he says that he wished he had the opportunity to explore it. He wanted to explore how Robin died, how Joker killed him, and how he burned down Wayne Manor. He clearly alluded to it in BVS, because there was a Robin suit there with "Haha, the joke's on you."
And this was something that I had talked about in our show, where my assumption was that when I saw that image, it would be flashbacks showing how Ben Affleck's Batman got to that position where the Joker had killed Robin and everything else. Unfortunately, that's not going to be the case with this, but as
who knows, money talks.
We'll all just kind of have to go along this ride together.
I mean, money talks, and if the Snyder Cut is as big of a hit as HBO is banking on, maybe they give him another movie. Who knows? We'll see what happens. He seems, the one thing, as much hate as Zack Snyder gets, the one thing he seems to be really good, well, two things he's really good at doing. One is casting. He is a brilliant casting director. He cast Wonder Woman, cast Jason Momoa, which redefined the Aquaman character, cast Ben Affleck, love him or hate him. It's definitely a grizzled take on Batman. You know, the guy takes risks when he casts people, and I can appreciate him for that. Mm-hmm. The other thing I think that he does really well is he gets Joss Whedon does not know how to motivate actors. He really does. They seem to really, really enjoy working for him. When he asked for people to come back for reshoots, it was like, no problem. Come on. We're happy to see you. Glad to see you back in it. And you've never heard, you know, a bad word about the guy. You know, he's been through some personal tragedy. But, you know, you compare him to Joss Whedon, who clearly seems to be, you know, on the world of the biggest frauds. You were
talking about Zack Snyder the whole time. You had mispronounced and said Joss Whedon at first. But Zack
Snyder
No,
I meant Zack Snyder.
That everyone loves.
I said Zack Snyder was a great... No, people don't love him.
Yes.
I think he gets derided than he should.
He gets the job done. And whereas Joss Whedon, and we've found that this happened more lately than we have... That Whedon apparently is a nightmare to work for. And that's actually something I didn't see coming as well.
Oh, I saw it.
Considering this is the guy that did Firefly and Serenity and a lot of other projects that I did love through the years. But when you look back and you see some of the
things that he's done. He was a fake feminist. You could see it when he was speaking publicly. He was a fake feminist.
You do look back now and see like, oh, you know, 2 and 2 do add up to 5.
It's almost like when you see people screaming about, like, maybe it's whether it's religious overtones or political overtones, and they're screaming at people. Those who scream the loudest have the most to hide. So those are just our 2 cents. I think he looks like he smeared stuff on his face, but I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. I'm excited to see it. I like Zack Snyder. He seems to put people in a good position. From his Suicide Squad cut says there's a lot more to the Joker than we saw. Dude was barely even in the movie, so it's hard to give him, you know, people hate that Jared Leto Joker, but I think this might be a redeem for him. We'll see what happens. Tell us what you think. Do you think he's going to be able to redeem himself? I don't know.
I think I'm looking forward to this. I think that a lot of people like to him and haul over stuff just because they have miserable existences, and that's today's world. But I think we really do have to just go along for the ride on this Snyder Cut, see what happens. Don't go in with expectations. Don't go in expecting to hate it. And fingers crossed, we're going to have something really cool on the other side.
Ride that pony. So if you like what you heard, subscribe, like, all that good stuff. We'll see y'all on the next one, and we love y'all. Peace.